You know what goes really well with mojito? Coffee. And not just any coffee. Colombian coffee is one that is renowned for its lingering taste and texture. Yona Gamoy shares a cup with Colombia's ambassador Luis Diego Monsalve Hoyos as he shares precious memories and goals before he says goodbye to China next year.
If you want the real coffee, have black coffee, no sugar. That's then second, but
I have sugar.
I know.
I am a big fan of coffee, and I know Colombia is the biggest coffee exporter in the world after Vietnam and Brazil. Please tell us more about Colombian coffee.
We say, and I think that's true, that Colombia's coffee is the best in the world. There are two big varieties of coffee. One is Arabica, which is mostly Colombian coffee, and the other one is Robusta. The production is mostly made by small farms with the owners, which they are directly picking the beans and picking the grains mainly by hand. You are looking at the,
yes,
at the logo.
Yes, I observe the logo here, Café de Colombia.
We have the National Federation of Coffee Growers. They came out with the idea of having one special like a logo of the imaginary coffee producer. So he is Juan Valdez, and he has his mule. So you see there the mule beside
here.
Him, Conchita. Here at the embassy, we have many artifacts, mm-hmm. which are copies, not the originals, from our gold museum. We have 31 different figures. This is worldwide known. Colombia and the north part of South America was one of the areas where the indigenous people, before the conquest by the Spanish when they came, they really handicraft and work a lot with the gold.
Everyone in Colombia is a good dancer. What do you think about that?
Oh, that's most probably true. No, I think of course there are many kind of people, but yeah, we like to dance. This is part of our DNA, I'd say.
Actually, some of your artists uh-huh. are very popular nowadays, kind of all over the world, but yes. especially in China. Uh-huh. What do you think about that? Well, how do you feel as the ambassador of Colombia when you go out and you hear the Colombian music?
It's very
playing?
Nice. Yeah, it's very nice. I mean, there are some artists like Shakira, which is well known around the world. She has this very specific style mm-hmm. with dancing and singing. And lately, in the last 10 years, there are very well-known artists which are very international, like J Balvin or Maluma. I think this is a kind of music that connects young people. Mm. So people, it's urban, it's some cool style music, so people can listen to it, can follow the rhythm, can dance. Yeah, when I go out here sometimes in these bars or places in some cities in China, I listen to the music and say, yeah, this is Colombian music, it's very nice.
I like this one. It actually matches my outfit a lot,
yes,
my shoes and
yes,
everything.
It is.
Tell us about these.
Okay, let me start with the one I'm wearing. We call it carriel. There are different versions of where it comes from, but probably the most real, it comes from an English term of carry-all. So these are different. These are Wayuu bags. And this is it's handicraft. It takes a lot of work. It's very popular and people like it, and it's already been sold all over the world.
Where are you from, Colombia?
I'm from Medellin. Medellin is the second largest city in Colombia. It's located in a valley. It's a very nice city. We call it the city of eternal spring. Kind of like Kunming here in China.
What does the mission you have here in China means for you and your family?
It's been a completely different experience. It's a wonderful country. It's been tough, especially this last year and a half, without being able to travel abroad. On the other hand, it's been really interesting to go all over the country here in China. I visited around 25 provinces, cities.
We're gonna talk about that.
Yes. Back home or some other places, they are in really lockdown, so the difference is good for being here right now.
I am curious, in general, how does a typical day in your life as an ambassador here in China looks like?
First of all, I think there's no typical day.
There is no free time.
When you are an ambassador, sometimes you may be 24/7. I may have some free time late in the afternoons or during the weekends also, of course. So I like to, first of all, travel is my favorite pastime. I really like to go and visit places.
What was one of the most memorable places you visited in China?
There's not only one. There are many. But let me tell you one which really impressed me. I think
Please. It
was in Gansu province, the Dongguan, the grotto, the caves, the Buddhist caves. They are beautiful. I also liked, for example, very much in Yunnan province. I went to Dali, Lijiang, Shangri-La, which are marvelous. A few weeks ago, I went to Guilin in the south. Beautiful place also.
Never been there.
Yeah, that's a wonderful place. No, If you tell me, I could have a list of 20 or 30 places, but every time, and I take a lot of pictures, of course, and you tell me, I try to share one or two of them when I go. I share them in my moments.
Yes, and that makes us very, very jealous.
Yes. I'm not trying to make a record, of course, but I hope that by the end of my time here, I will be able to visit all the provinces at least once.
And now I would like to ask you about Beijing.
Yes.
What do you do for fun here, and where do you spend your time besides the embassy?
Okay. As I told you, the less the better. So no, of course, I like the place. The embassy is a very nice place, but I like to go out. For example, the Summer Palace is a beautiful place. I've been probably 5 times to the Great Wall. The hutongs, I mean, walking on the hutongs and getting lost on the hutongs.
Yeah.
And finding the people there.
Indeed, that's an experience.
Yes, that's a very nice experience. I think Beijing is a magical place. Beijing has the modern areas, the old areas, the imperial places. Of course, Forbidden City is a beautiful place to visit as many times as you can.
How about fun? Favorite restaurant, for example. Tell me your favorite restaurant.
I think there are many places, many favorite.
You cannot mention one. I know.
Here in this area of CDB plus San Litun, there is one place where you meet a lot of foreigners, like Nali Patio, Nali Garden. There are many
Nali
good
restaurants. Nali Patio,
yes, in San Litun. Yes. So there are many nice foreign restaurants where you will meet a lot of expats over there.
Aside from the governmental relations,
yes.
What do you do to promote the relationship between the two countries?
The main job here is to keep talking with the central government, Chinese central government, as ambassador. But apart from that, number one, there is very important, a lot of opportunities to have with provincial and local governments. This is something we are trying to work now to get connected the provinces and the cities, many provinces and cities of China, with cities and provinces back in my country. Apart from that, once again, business. I go and I try to connect with Chinese companies, SOEs, infrastructure companies that are making projects in Colombia, or we are inviting them to come to Colombia. Culture. There are many museums and cultural places here where we want to try and to make cultural exchanges.
Keep us updated with everything you'll do.
Yes, please, of course.
Thank you so much for this interview.
My pleasure.
And it was a pleasure to meet you. And
thank you
so much for showing us around your residence and the embassy.
Yes, it's a pleasure. Always welcome here. I think Colombian Embassy is your place, it's your home.